Hello YouTube, today at powerjackrepair.org we have a powerjackrepair. All right, we have the MSI laptop. It's MS-16W1 NL Eindhoven. Let me zoom in right here. Eindhoven 5706-5692-ER. That's ER Sun. Which particular model that is, I don't know, maybe GF62, maybe GF672 or something like that. I will look it up later on and probably put it in the description. The problem is the usual. We only deal with power jacks, as you understand. We got 1,000+ videos on this channel. So this is not exactly your laptop make and model. You can probably find it on our channel. We accept donations, we accept the new business, so if you have exactly the same problem, you could send us just the motherboard, it's gonna be that much. Or if you send us the whole laptop, it's gonna be that much. The price is probably gonna change because we already have price increases across the everything, seems like. So, you know, if you're watching it in like 2025, maybe those rates are not applicable. Anyways, let's take it apart and show you how, if you want, you can fix it yourself again. I'm not greedy for the information. So, let's see. Just unscrew the bottom. Now you should understand that I have done thousands of, tens of thousands of power jack repairs in my life. Not really 100,000, but tens of thousands. And, you know, just using a regular screw like that on all of the screws, you know, you get a whole bunch of issues in your joints and arms if you're gonna be screwing like that. So you can just use just a regular screwdriver to unscrew all of that. Now, where is my favorite tool here? It's been a while since I used the studio because we got kind of labor shortages now. So I have no time to record any videos. So I just have to get everything out of here, whatever comes in. But one day, maybe by 2022, I would be able to hire some people, train them, hire them. Maybe people would need to make money. Let's see, now this has a crack here, it has some sort of crack right here. So I'm just being gentle. Let's not cause any more damages. We got two more stuffs falling out right here. Let's see, nothing else falling out here. All right. So, now the thing is, I had a repair done and the client complained that the speaker is no longer working. So I think I forgot to connect the speakers on that previous repair. Now this guy is probably glued in, and it's probably glued in pretty heavily. Yeah, so when you're gonna be tearing this guy apart, you might break the battery, which I might do as well here. Who knows? I don't know, but I would like to disconnect the battery first, but it's probably not gonna happen because the angle right there, I mean, there's not much room to disconnect this guy. And people break off those connectors all the time, so try not to. Strange, this seems like a new fan. This one has a whole bunch of mold on it. Maybe this one doesn't work. All right, so enough talk, let's do some action here. The battery is the biggest pain usually to take apart. So I'm just gonna put this guy right there as a leverage. Let's see. Nope, doesn't want to go. Let's find another one of those. Let's clean up this guy first. I just don't like all of the environment getting dusty here. Let's put one of those guys right there. Hopefully maybe something like that. Nothing like that. Let's see. Come on, go in. And go up. As you can see, this is kind of a flexible, it's not a knife, it's a flexible taking apart kind of tool, which usually unnecessary, but for this case I think. Okay, just don't want to break the battery in any way, shape or form. Let's see, maybe we got another tool of some sort here. Let's find this guy. Okay, like that. Like that, let's see if we can just... Come on. Come on. Like that. Alright, so this tool works wonders for the future. Alright, so now we're just gonna pull on this connector slightly. Carefully. Alright, so we take that guy out. Let's put this guy away. Let's put that guy away. The reason you don't want to do too much shoveling right here, you might damage this cable, and you're probably not gonna be able to find this cable anywhere. You might damage this cable. Again, this is kind of a rare system. I'm pretty sure that there's not going to be many views on this video, because I don't really think... Oh, and the jack right here is missing altogether, so you can put a finger in here. So wow, I haven't seen much of that ever. So careful with those connections right here. What you want to do is you want to pull on the cable upwards. At the same time, you want to hold down this clip downwards, otherwise you're gonna rip it apart. Same here, hold down the clip, pull up on the plug. All right so here we got the two connections here. Okay, we got the sound connection here, which I forgot to connect to previous client. He emailed me saying, listen, the speakers don't work, and I'm like, take the laptop apart on the bottom and connect this cable, and that's gonna be your speakers right here. It just sometimes when you put the motherboard in, this falls under it and you can't really see it. So here we got the LED LCD cable. Be extremely careful about that, because there is no way anybody gonna be solder that. I mean, somebody, I could solder that, but I just don't have time for it, because I could get 10 laptops done in time. It would take me to solder this guy properly in there. So everything is fixable, guys, but it just the time I don't have. I have the time to fix the jacks, I don't have time to fix the connectors. So be extremely careful again. So if you're sending us just the motherboard, this video is so that if you want to save some money, you could send us just the motherboard. I'm telling you, careful about this hinge right here. Those guys, you know, it's all fixable, but I don't wanna do more work than needed. So sometimes it's better just to send the whole laptop, quite honestly. Alrighty, so here I got some sort of a new bracket of some type, so let's connect that. And those are same screws, right? So they're gonna go in a separate bin. So we're gonna put this wireless card in there, and that guy gonna be like that. Alright, the good thing they don't even put hard drives in those anymore. Okay, come. Like that. And this bracket probably needs to be removed, because I got those cables under that bracket. So let's see. Oh yeah, by the way, if it's not too much trouble, just press a like button on the bottom. It just helps the channel grow and helps people on Google to find me better here. Alrighty, so, and there's really no other channel that's gonna show you all this down to the T on how to solder, how to desolder, how to take the laptop apart. Most of the channels are pretty much sales. They're like, here, you wanna buy this MSI laptop? No, you don't wanna buy an MSI laptop. One day I'm gonna make a video with the rating of the which laptops I would buy and which ones I wouldn't. But still have no time to do that. It just, again, once I hire some people to work, then yeah, but right now have to deal with this. All right, so like that. All right, so we got three screws right here. We got three screws right there. Alrighty. Okay. And I think they're gonna come up with the heatsink. And here what you wanna do is you wanna see how this cable lays down here, so that you would assemble exactly the same way, because you see like the screws right there, the cable's on top of it. So there's a little bit of guiding to be done here. Now this cable you want to disconnect right here. There's another cable when you flip the motherboard, two cables I think. So don't pull the motherboard out once you unscrew everything. Alright, so here we got this guy. We got this. 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 Okay. All right. Okay, so we want to be extra careful, and we want to move it upwards because there are paddings right there which you don't want to kind of rock to the left or to the right, because they're just gonna break. So it's only upward motion, not side to side motion. Don't press on those capacitors, because there's a pain to solder them, and I don't have any of them in stock, and I don't want to transfer any of them from donor boards. So don't break those capacitors here. Make sure you're gonna be pulling it all upwards. All right. Oh, by the way, maybe you don't. No, you do have to take it off because this cable is in the way. All right. So here, let's do something like that. Can we guide this cable out? Maybe, maybe not. Again, don't bend this cable too much in any way, shape, or form, because you're not gonna be able to find a replacement part anywhere. Well, not in 2021. As you know, that we got shortages of everything, so here. Okay. And let's see if you wanna. Okay. Okay. Let's see, can we lift up this guy? Okay, good job. So you see, those are the rubber pads, not the rubber, the silicone pads that you don't want to lose. You don't want to move them anywhere. Just keep them right where they at. Okay, so we want to unscrew those two guys right here, because once you lose those pads, something gonna fry. Those guys gonna fry, those guys gonna fry, all of that fries like that. No, those guys are usually fine. Well, once they get miscalibrated, that means they are fried. Those chips right there are proprietary chips. You're not gonna find them anywhere, pretty much. Again, if companies can't make a car, let alone anybody would be able to make a laptop without the parts needed. So here we want to flip this guy over. You want to disconnect this cable right here. You want to disconnect that cable right there. Alright. And this cable is just fine. We don't have to touch it. I mean, it seems fine. Alright, so here, what you want to do next is this. I don't want to lose those pads. And if you're shipping this whole thing to us, just put everything back on like this. Make sure the box is big enough, because there is not much room here for a new connector. Well, you know what, how about we're gonna do this first. I'm afraid for those silicon pads to... That's it, that's all I got. This is an overkill right here, what I'm doing. Usually don't have to do it, it just I'm doing it because I don't want to spend a day fixing something that didn't need to be broken in the first place. So I'm insulating the components right next to the jack. Usually it's a captain tape. This is the captain tape right here. You could buy from the link below, by the way. All of the tools you could buy from the link below. This is the captain tape that we usually use. Basically, you just take it too much, the captain tape like that. I shouldn't have lifted this whole thing. It will get sticky. Okay, so you got the point. The captain tape, you can just put captain tape on top of the port, and it's gonna hold the insulation just fine. I got to the point where I just use this 3M high temperature insulation. You can probably use a foil, but foil doesn't stick. This one sticks. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add some well, let me show you. I'm out of tape already. Now I need to order the tape. You know what, let me go order the tape, and because, you know, I'm not gonna sleep well at night knowing that I forgot something. So just hold on 1 second. Alrighty, so let's the party continue. Problem here is I'm not sure which jack goes in here. I have three jacks that I know are gonna fit the motherboard. It's just I'm not sure. They have a different height, basically. Some sitting higher, some sitting lower. So it doesn't want to come out for some reason. Here. Maybe my... hold on 1 second. Let's put some plugs right there, right here. Now, it's better if you wouldn't take the jack like that off of motherboard. It's easier to take the jack off the motherboard when it's all together, not when it's like broken off like that. So here, I'm just gonna add some new solder so that the new solder gonna mix with the old solder. Right. The new solder gonna mix with the old solder. Come on. Yeah, nothing wanna come out because because everything is broken already. So again, much easier to take it all apart when it's all assembled together. I mean, when the jack is still there. Again, what I'm doing is I'm diluting the old solder, because that's a silver based solder, and I'm adding the regular solder, the leaded based solder. Okay. Alrighty. Come on. Go out. Alright. Let's see if we can just do... We can just... Ay-yi-yi-yi-yi. Usually it's much easier process here, but you know, each case is different, so. Oh, Let's see if we at least can get this guy out. Nope. Alright, well. You know what, it was my mistake. I needed to reduce the airflow and add a little bit more heat, basically. So now, once the heat is added, I can pretty sure like that, yeah. Let's take this guy out like that. Let's take this guy out. Yeah. I didn't look at the settings for the heat gun. They looked the way how I usually leave them, but they were left differently this time around. Because again, I haven't used the station in quite some time, because no time to make videos, guys. Just keep working 7 days a week. Alrighty. Okay. So these guys we're gonna take out using just the hot air, probably. Let's see. Come on. Let's see if you're gonna be able to just take it out using the hot air. Come on. Nope, we can't. Not hot enough. All right. No big deal here. Okay. This is... this is just a pain to deal with here like that. All right, let's do this guy. Come on. Nope. Such is life. Yeah. So this we removed. That guy we removed. Again, I'm just removing the remains of the broken jack. Alrighty. Okay, I got two more legs stuck right here. Again, it's much easier for me just pull off the whole jack off of the motherboard instead of doing what I'm doing here right now. Okay. You see, it's all heats up right away, so I have no time to push the guys through. Let's try the other. Again, you don't have to deal with all of that unless you already cut the jack completely off the board, which you shouldn't do in the first place, but I just have to deal with this. Okay. Okay, good job. Okay, so the pieces are right here, probably. We're just gonna take them off like that. Let's take them off like that. Okay, looks good. Now let's desolder all of the solder from the motherboard. Okay, looks good to me. Alrighty. Okay, good job. All right, so we got something like that going on here. Okay. Now this is what we got here. One of the jacks seems to be aligned fine with this top end. So let's solder it up and see if it's gonna be a good fit here. Like that. You know what, the rear holes are not as clean as I want them to be. So here, let's put the hot air on it one more time. Let's pour the new let's fill every hole with the new solder, because the silver based solder didn't want to come out as easily as I was hoping for. All right, so let's fill every one of those holes right here. All right, now let's see if you can do a really good job at cleaning up every single hole perfectly fine, because the jack didn't want to sit easily in there. All right, so this one is fine. Let's see if you can do this guy. This guy also looks to be fine. Yeah, the new solder basically makes the trick of cleaning up everything nice and easy. All right. Okay. Let's do this guy a bit more. Up like that. A bit like that. A bit here, there. Alrighty. Good job. Okay, looks good. Now, yeah, all of the holes are nice and empty, as you can see. And now the new jack should fit just fine, yep. Because prior to that, it didn't really fit the way I... It didn't really want to fit the way I wanted to hit, to fit. Everything is so hot in there. All right. You know what, I probably have to do it top down, because when I flip it over, it doesn't want to stay in place as well as I want it to stay in place. Okay. So let's see if we can just put some tack on solder. Right there. Okay. Oh, out of your sight. I'm still not happy with the way how this thing is positioned. And that's not something I want to do now. Hold on. It's not sitting as perfectly as I want it to sit. So let's do. Let's do a little bit here, flags there. I wanted to sit slightly deeper on this end right here. All right. Now it came out. All right. So here. Like that. You know, the better it sits in the motherboard, the less chances that the client gonna break it again. All right. So like that. And like that. Now should be good. Let's take a look. Yeah, now it should be much better. Again, not sure if this is the right jack for it. I will see once I put it into the casing. But so far so good. All right. Let's do a really good soldering job right here on the rear pin. Good soldering job on the rear pins for the negatives. All right. Yeah, looks good to me. We can even bridge those two. So that. Okay, good job. And good job. Okay. All right, so now my goal is to solder everything from the top as well as the, you know, already soldered from the bottom. So now is the goal to add some solder from the top. So it would be really nice and sturdy right there like that. Good job. Looks good to me. Okay. And come on. Alrighty, looks good to me. So I did kind of bridge those two connections together. I think I need to unbridge them now because it seems excessive to me right now. Yep. Okay. Much harder to unbreach. Where is the flux at? The solder is so good that it doesn't wanna get desoldered anymore. Let's do. No, seriously? What's going on? Is it my soldering iron? Oh, my soldering iron came when kaput, guys. The tip worn out from all the usage. Take a look right there. You see there's a hole at the tip. Yeah, no, but I mean, it worked fine for many years, but yeah. I got plenty of tips, no big deal, I didn't expect I never seen a tip being worn out so much. Alright. Yeah, time to replace a tip. Alright, so unfortunately, the heating element is taking a long time to cool down here. But this is basically the final job. I had to finish it up on a different station, which is not set up for making videos, but this is it right there. You see, it's soldered from the both top and bottom, and the jack will be pretty much forever, assuming the tip of the cord is fine. You see how it's soldered in the back right there? So, yeah. Make sure all of the pads, all of the rubber pads are still in place. Right here. And now let's assemble it back. Well, before I'm gonna take the rubber gloves off, by the way, I already ordered the new 3M energy saving products right there. That's a tape. It's already got delivered. I'm just kidding. No, I had some extra around, as it turns out. So let me clean up this guy, this guy, that guy, and that guy, so that I would be able to put the new thermal paste on. All right, so this guy is clean, this guy is clean. This guy is clean, and that guy is relatively clean. Okay, so let me measure to see if this one is shorting or not. We're just gonna put it like that. I know it's an analog, but I've been doing that for a long, long, long time, and it's much easier for me to use analog than digital. I got a whole bunch of digital equipment right there. I just want to make sure that everything is conduct. Whatever works, it does exactly the same thing. Okay, looks good to me. Looks great. Okay, so this should be just fine. Here is the digital. All right. Just so many people complain that you're still using the analog voltmeter. It works. It's been working fine. Sometimes it works better than the digital stuff. So, all right, here. Okay, like that. And I need to put it down. That. Not 100% sure if it's all in there. Come on. Okay. That should be good. So you see, that's when I put the motherboard in this cable. I sometimes forget to connect. So, like that. Not sometimes, just once in a lifetime, but the client wasn't exactly happy. Go in and reconnect the cable. All right, so here we're gonna put this cable like that. For some reason it doesn't fit. Okay, like that. Okay, looks good to me. Looks good to me. Okay. Forgot to forgot the reason why I have the That's the main reason why I have the rubber gloves on, because I need to put the thermal paste in. Everybody's seeing, asking, do you put a new thermal paste in? Yes, yes, always. Those are like $5 a piece, I don't know, $10, maybe $20, don't know. It's not like it matters. I mean, this tube is enough for hundreds and hundreds of repairs. It's a huge tube, so. And I buy them in bulk, so. It's really nothing worth even asking about. So here, I think this screw gonna be, I need some favorite screwdrivers from this table down to alright, any day now. Not exactly my favorite screwdriver, but it's gonna do the job. Okay, so one right here. Okay. That's the reason I didn't take the rubber gloves off yet. Because I still need to do this. Okay. Okay, good job. And now I can throw away the rubber gloves. Okay, so here. Good, 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 good. Looks good to me disconnected. Let's connect this guy as well. This is a tricky connection. You kind of have to slide it under the two pins right there, one to the left, one to the right, and then you close it down. Okay. This guy, we probably can't connect it yet because I remember there was something not perfectly well aligned there here. Let's see. So here we're gonna put it like that, right? Like that. And we have another screw we're gonna put right here. Okay. And now we should be able to get this guy like that, and like that. I'm not tightening any of them up, I'm just making sure that all of them are gonna be properly. And yeah, I can see the reason why I don't tighten them up yet. Because I have to put this guy right here first. Okay. Then we're gonna put this screw right here. Now is a good time to tighten it. Now you don't wanna over tighten anything. This is not lug nuts on the car. Maybe you wanna screw down this guy. Okay. Told you, not my favorite screwdriver. Not my favorite screwdriver at all.
Do you have something else to screw it with? I should have. Here someplace. Let's do this guy. Also not the best screwdriver. Found that it was at the soldering station. All right, so now the job gonna be much easier and faster. So here. All right. This one allows me to press down and screw at the same time. All right. Okay. 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 Good job. Okay. Okay. Alright. Now we want to connect this guy. The LED LCD cable. Not sure what we got here. Probably LED. Alright, and we got one more screw going in. Right here. Come on. Yeah? No.
Wrong screw.
I was on the oh, it's probably gonna go from the top down.
Okay.
Never mind. So here. This is a kind of a tricky proposition here. Like that. Like that. Okay. No, yeah, no. Come on. Okay, like that. Like that, and like that. Okay. So my understanding, this guy was right here. All right. And this guy was right here, probably. Okay, and I think we got one more right there, if I'm not mistaken. Okay. So we want to screw down the you see the pad here and the pad right there. Make sure the pads are right where you left them off. Okay. We're just gonna screw down right here. So those screws right here and for the wireless card are different screws. Again, guys, if it's not too much trouble, just please leave a like. Helps the channel a lot. Or you could make a comment saying, you know, good job. That makes channel, that helps on, helps the channel way more. I mean, the comment, whatever you, doesn't matter what you write there. It's usually rates the video much higher when there's a whole bunch of comments. Okay, like that. And quite honestly, it doesn't really make the difference which one gonna connect to which, as long as they both connected. I mean, even if one of them is connected, it's still gonna work. The wireless connection gonna work. I'm just gonna put some extra tape on it, just so it would not be going anywhere. Now, the laptop came in without the power supply. So I don't know what kind of type of power supply this laptop uses. I just wanna make sure that the holes are gonna align here. Hopefully with the casing. All right, so here we got the okay, like that and like that. Good job.
Now let's put
the battery. I would probably want to connect it first. Like that, and then I want to guide it and put it in. Nope, hold on, like that. Make sure it's nice and straight going inwards. All right, it looks good to me. Yep.
Sounds good.
Okay.
Looks good. Let's make sure the hinges are tightened up. Screwdriver, let's see. Yeah, they're all good. Okay. Let's put the bottom cover on. So we connected pretty much everything, I think, right? Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I guess this one's gonna go like that. An angle. I need to lift up the motherboard right here slightly. Okay. Oh, here. They removed the jack like that. You see? Figured it's gonna be what working. Anyways, sometimes. And you wonder, you know, how did the people remove the jack? Strange. So it's easy. Just pry out the casing. Now, let's see. All right. All right. Okay. Good job. And you see why the gloves are dirty? Because I have to collect all this silicone table as it remains. All right, so let me go look for the power supply for this laptop. I want to see how much do we need here. 9.32 amps. I don't even have something like this powerful, but I'm pretty sure I would be able to find something close to what we need. Give me 1 second. All right, my friends, so I found the Dell power supply, which is, well, it doesn't want to get so far out here, 6.7 amps. It has a Dell plug like that, so I put the dongle, that's the dongle I created myself. All right, so we got 20 watts. Let's see. And I was worried about the hole on the cord on the casing not aligning. Let's see if I would be able to just put this guy in there. Okay. Let's see. I don't see any lights anywhere. Is there a light? Someplace? I think there should be light. I mean, it's an expensive system, so I assume. Oh, yeah. So there is a light right here. Means the battery is charging. Right, let's power it up. And I think something isn't right with the resolution because it's... Strange, I will take a look at what resolution you're getting when I'm recording this video. Alright, so let's hope something gonna come up on the screen. Overall, the laptop is good in terms of hopefully I'm gonna make money out of it. So right there, MSI. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. Please leave a like, subscribe. I will let you know which brands of the laptops I would buy for myself if I would have the money. You know what? I don't even have a laptop. I mean, I have a laptop that's like 5-10 years old, Dell laptop, which I used to to stream some stuff onto the TV, but in general, I don't really even use a laptop. I don't see a need for one. I mean, if I travel someplace, there's obviously the smartphone, and I don't really travel that much because of the 2019-20 to 2021 events, plus, you know, there is no people who want to work nowadays, so you can't really leave your business unattended. It's kind of okay. Let's see if that slides. Okay, so I'm still hoping for it to load up to show you the icon on the lower right hand corner, but I mean, you saw that white light is there. It does power up. Again, it powers up again. Anyways, should work. Thanks so much for watching, and you guys take care and have a good day. Thanks. Bye.